don't think they will now. But it's not affecting you, is it?
Oh! be interested to know that we have what we call a choral connection with Potchefstroom University, and we have some students that come to the Drakensberg Boys Choir for a year to study choir training, and when they complete their exam and their thesis, they get a certificate from Potch University, and we've had, very happy to have had, a Norwegian student with us for the last year. His name is Håkon Skrede. He's going to take us through the next piece, a few pieces. Please welcome Håkon.
Oh! by Benjamin Britten in 1930. And as you know, he's one of the famous English composers of this century. It is in English and in Latin. And the Latin part is from a text from the 13th century. Very nice. Enjoy.
Thank you.
video cameras around. They're rather like sharpshooters. You know, wherever you look in a situation like that, you see somebody with a camera. But you may be interested to know that they are filming specifically one of our boys for a program that will appear next year on SABC2, and it's going to be called Diaries on Fire, probably in January, probably at 4:45, and probably on SABC2. But it definitely will appear. And the boy that they are filming is Sandile Mabaso from Corkster. Like this, his arms got stuck in this position for about the last month. And tonight they've kindly come along to film this particular concert. And I noticed that they've taken a couple of shots of the audience, and I noticed that's why you're applauding so beautifully. So if you want to see yourselves sometime, probably in January, probably at 4:45, and probably on SNBC2, just put the TV on. And now we're going to sing for you Easter hymn, which is from Cavalleria Rusticana by Mascagni. The soloist right at the end is Gareth Trent.
Thank you.
English staff are clearly marvelled at the talent and excellence of these young boys' performance. It is quite remarkable when you come to consider that the average age of a boy performing here tonight is 12. This talent and excellence does not happen overnight. And apart from a very long academic day and sporting program that these boys follow, they have 2 hours daily of choral practice and 45 minutes of music theory. In addition to this, many of these boys have individual voice and instrumental times and lessons, and for this they require half an hour to 2 hours daily of practice time. Although Drakensberg boys' choir is an all-encompassing term, the boys at the school are divided into two choirs, each of equal strength, their own choir master and accompanist. Touring plays a very big part of our school life, and boys do local festivals, local conferences, and local tours like this one. And at the end of the year, they embark on a rather arduous No World Tour. But possibly for any of the boys that you might meet tonight and have a chance to chat to, they will tell you that possibly the greatest part about being a Drakensberg is being selected for the international choir. This is where 38 of our top choristers are chosen to represent our school and indeed South Africa overseas. Ladies and gentlemen, that there's many, many ambassadors, especially on the sporting field. And this morning we saw Amaboko Boko do justice out on the field. And of course we have a failure and possibly one of the only cultural instruments that this country has is the Drakensberg Boys Choir. They're one of the first South African artists to appear behind the Iron Curtain. And they were ranked the world's best boys choir when singing alongside the likes of the American Boys Choir and the Vienna Boys Choir. And this happened in Poznan in Poland in 1992.
I would like to make a very special apology because there are several boys' names who are not on the program tonight. Ivan Pienz, Paul Goodday, Sander Kritzinger, Wesley Diebel, and Kebala Kamelo Diale. And as Murphy's Law would have it, two of them are from Winchester roots, so I'm really, really sorry about that. And talking about that, Wesley and Clinton and Tato and Carvero are our four very splendid boys who come from this school, and we are very happy to have them. They're wonderful products of the school. Can you just show us who you are?
Oh. Thank you.
sincere role of theatricalness. And now I'm going to invite Wolfgang back on stage to take you through the next number, Wolfgang.
Next piece is a fun piece. Enjoy it. The text, by the way, is about the falling red. Everybody has decided. So you're thinking about the red going up.
Thank you.
Barrett, who you met earlier on, right at the beginning of the concert, we have the two Pereira boys, Gennaro and João. Are there any other old boys in the audience tonight? Well, I'm pleased, because there are only four people are going to come to me and say it was much better when I was at the Drakensberg. welcome to you, and thank you for your support this evening. We appreciate it very much. I notice also that we have parents. You know, we have the most wonderfully loyal parents at the Drakensberg Boys Choir School. They come from far and near, and I see the good day sitting over there from Swaziland. Welcome. Now we're going to sing for you a Serbian folk song. It's called Niška Banja. And it's all about some young people who go down to the fountain to kiss. And that's what we think they're doing. And every time they kiss, you will hear a squeal. So you know exactly what it is, girls. The two pianists are on your right-hand side. Here we go. Who is our musical leader, and Andrew Henderson-Jones on your left. He is from East London. He is from Rutherford. Thank you. sing for you excerpts from Lion King, which was here on that CD.
Yeah.
sing for you a couple of numbers from this chamber choir. And the first one is Can't Buy Me Love by the Beatles.
I'll buy you a diamond ring, my friend, if it makes you feel all right. I'll get you anything, my friend, if it makes you feel all right. I don't care too much for money, but God buy me love, God buy me love. I may not have a lot to give, but God, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money, but God, buy me love, la 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 la.
Thank you.
so low, you've got to pick them up just to say hello.
They've got little cars that go beep, beep, beep. They've got little horses go beep, beep, beep. Well, I don't want to show
down.
us a moment of your patience while we sort out the stage for the last part of the program. Today is our second night here, and it's lovely to have such a warm welcome. You notice at the back there, there's some lovely drawings with words, fire, and letters, each one, and also the foyer. If you missed it on the way in, have a look at it on the way out. It's really very charming. And we feel very welcome here, and thank you very much indeed. And to Mrs. Rosemary Wilkie for arranging the concert, and to the headmaster, Mr. Harris, who would like to say on behalf of the Drakensberg Boys Choir, thank you very much indeed. And last, but certainly not least, a very big thank you to you, the audience, tonight for supporting us on a cold evening, for missing the event, and for being here to hear a live performance. It certainly glads our hearts, and thank you very much. The last part of the program is an African adventure. We sing these songs as originally as possible, with as little arranging of the notes as possible. They come to us, come to you as they came to us. And we use a lot of instruments, African instruments. Some of them are made in the factory in Grahamstown, the African Music Instrument Factory. They're very careful and very nice copies. Some of them are made in our own valley. Some of the songs we've learnt from boys will be to the Drakensberg Boys Choir. Other songs from choirs that have been to us, and other songs from schools in our area. So it really is the substance of Africa that you're going to hear now. The first song is Mawonela, which is a Sotho worm song, and it's usually sung when the people are hoeing. And they ask Mawonela, who is the lead singer and the person in charge, not to be too hard on them. And then Sesio Sobenza, the men arrive ready to work. And they do so by singing the song by Yan Noyika. I can hear myself coming out of the roof. By Yan Noyika, it's a work song that's not associated with a particular work activity, but it is a work song. And then we sing for you a charming wedding song, Uti Wena, and it has a strong Christian influence in it. It says, Father, you created a male and female. You spoke the word which still stands today. Let the man cleave to his wife and children. And then the gumboot dance, which is well known in South Africa. It comes from the mines. Now, there are various different types of gumboot dances. This is just one that we do, one particular one. And then we join in, the whole choir joins in with a gumboot dance when they sing Molo Molo, which is a Swati song about a duck. And then we do an akadinda number. The akadinda is a log xylophone from Central Africa. And the western xylophones are played in the center. These ones are played outside, so you can fit more than one player on. In fact, we fit four players onto the akadinda, and they all play their own tunes. And the tunes have to fit between the notes of the other tunes. So it's actually quite complex. And when all the xylophone players are playing, the drums come in two times, three time and four time, and it's quite a miracle if we all stay together. It's brought to a close by the blowing of a kudu horn. And then Insikana's bell is a very interesting piece. Insikana was a missionary in South Africa in a remote valley, and he didn't have a church. He didn't have a church bell, and so he would sing this particular song on Sundays, which would remind his congregation that it was Sunday that they ought to come to church. And as they came up the valley, they would join in the singing. And so it became known as Insikana's bell. And then the Symphony of Africa by night. You mustn't imagine that you're in a suburb of Johannesburg before, but that you're out in the bushveld and you're sitting around a campfire, and that you're hearing the Symphony of Africa by night. And you're going to hear fish frogs, painted reed frogs, ordinary quark frogs, some pretty big ones, I can tell you. And some African nightjars, spotted owls, and even the lion roaring in the distance, and the sound of long-awaited gentle rain. When we sing this overseas, people don't realize how important rain is to us, but we all do. So you hear that lovely sound of rain coming eventually, just before the lullaby, or maybe it's just after as well. The lullaby is sung when it's all nice and quiet. Beautiful lullaby by Tola Tola, usually sung by the eldest daughter to youngest, lulling the youngest to sleep, and it's accompanied on panpipes, buhari bows, and kalimbas. Kalimbas are the hand panners, buhari bow is the bowed stick with a piece of wire caught up in the middle, which gives you 2 minutes in the used bow. And then Jigla Maweni is, of course, a fighting song associated with circumcision. The adolescents down at the river practicing their stick fighting, and the their friends are encouraging and shouting them on. And then the last song on the program tonight of the African music of the whole program is by Yeza Kusasa, a Zulu party song about Noma Tokolo, a legendary character, and the translation is simply, "The spirits will be coming in the morning." Please enjoy the African music.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, there will be a 20-minute interval. The tuck shop will be in the foyer. Thank you.